Hello and welcome. I'm Tim Williams, Zaffa's Artistic Director. Tonight we show six brand new works written for accordion through our Composing for Accordion scheme for the virtuoso accordionist Miloš Milivojević. Thank you to the six emerging composers for taking the time to learn how to write for this complex instrument. I'm sure you'll enjoy the results. It's been a very difficult year with the COVID pandemic stopping arts organisations in the tracks. Zaffa is a UK registered charity and relies on public and private support to flourish. You can support our work through a simple text donation or by exploring the supporters pages of our website. In the past few weeks, we've supported the work of 35 composers through our schemes, commissions and projects. We also gave our first public performance at Halle St. Peter's since March. This performance was streamed live, and if you'd like to see it, it's still available through our YouTube channel. In the next couple of months, we have performances on the 12th of November and the 10th of December. We'll be giving those performances to a live audience, but we'll also be streaming them. So if you'd like to see those performances and you can't join us, why not? Go to our website and you'll find details of how to watch those live streams. All I need to do now is hand over to the composers and Miloš, and I hope you enjoy the evening.
Hello, I am William KZ, and my piece is called Cut the Chin Chord for solo accordion. It's simply called this because I wanted to see if I can get the accordion player to at one point have to play with his chin. The piece is based on European folk music but blended together with contemporary Western music. I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Silvia Rosani. I'm a composer, sound artist and researcher. I'm fascinated by ways to connect pre-existing music to new music, and that is why the piece I work on in collaboration with Miloš was born from the frequency analysis of an excerpt from one of the sonatas by Alessandro Scarlatti. The title, Assalti, comes from the extraction of letters from the subtitle after Scarlatti and is Italian for with lips, which depicts how the resynthesis of the original piece is made by jumping between different frequency bandwidths.
Hi, my name's Anna and my piece is called Wonders, and it kind of explores lots of different versions of the same motif in quite like a wandering way, and just wanted it to be very expressive and an exploration of kind of what happens when you've got a really small amount of material and it's explored to its fullest. Hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Having worked with a wonderful Psappha ensemble in the past, I was delighted to be asked to be part of composing for Scheme. And I'm very, very happy always to introduce this wonderful instrument to composers. They find it initially scary to write for, and I totally agree with them because it's very difficult to know where to start initially. It is one of the most sophisticated acoustic instruments in the world, and it takes a while for everyone to get to know it, both players and composers. And I was very happy during the process. I think we have six really wonderful and contrasting pieces. And I'm very much looking forward to hear them myself and also to perform them in the future. And I hope that also young players and everyone else will be performing them in many, many years to come.
My name is Joe Bates, and this is Two Animals. Two Animals imagines two breathing cycles, that of the accordionist and of their accordion. The music is written in counterpoint to the breath of the singing accordionist. I imagine it like two animals sitting together, their breath moving in and out of synchronicity until one is subsumed into the other.
Thank you. My name is Adam Sekondu. My piece is called Systole, Diastole in a Heartbeat, and it is inspired by the human cardiac cycle. The structure of the work is intended as a magnification of the single heartbeat. So the first two-fifths of the work correspond to the contraction of a beating heart, or systole, and the remaining three-fifths to the expansion of the heart, or diastole. For example, in the beginning, the harmonies get more and more condensed and the tempo gradually accelerates. After a climactic point comes the diastole section, where the harmonies keep getting expanded and the music finds stillness.
Hi, my name is Aidan Toplitsky, and my piece is called It's the Burden of Knowing. The idea for the piece came from wanting to understand the tension I feel between the lack of distinction between my work life and my leisure life. When I'm with friends or family, I'm not fully in the moment because I'm thinking about work, or I'm specifically thinking, why am I not working right now when I could be or I should be? This questioning of my work ethic and of my validity as an artist stems from being a composer from a working class background. And so I wanted to try and understand this struggle for worthiness within myself as an artist, and to feel I don't need to be on all the time in order to be valid as a creator.